Hey guys, Andrew here, and welcome back to another episode of Fidelio Incident. When we last left off, we were, can you run in this game? There we go. Okay. Brief running. A lot of stuff happened, but basically we got to this island full of bugs and whatever, and we have to try to get, god, this running is awful. We have to try to get that area cleared of bugs, that area right above us. In order to do that, we need to open that vent, which is right here. And we can't do that because this thing's blocking it. Oh no. Well, then how do you do that, Andrew? You might be asking yourself, because clearly you don't know what you're doing because this fucking, the vent's not open. And I would say, how rude. All you need to do is merely turn this off. See, now that it's turned off and that thing goes away. Ah. But here's the crux of the whole thing. If both of those are closed, then you can swivel swavel it over to two. And if it's swivel swaveled, then it means you can run your happy ass over here. Oops. And over here. And throw the switch that way. That unlocks this. You can do that. And what a bingo.
Now the path is clear.
Try to stay awake. Keep my mind on. Before the plane crashed, you didn't finish your story. About the time you stole the box of sweets. But I think I know exactly how it ended. Your dad, he knew what you'd done. He just didn't know why. Still, he never asked you about it. Never accused you of anything. So you never told him the truth. But it was always there, wasn't it? An abandoned space between you. Like an unfinished story.
She sounds so weak. Hang on, Leonore.
I mean, she's dying of hypothermia. Of course she sounds weak. She said she's trapped. Like, she's trapped at the top of a mountain. Yeah, she's gonna die.
I couldn't go to my father for help. He's all for letting Stanley take the fall. But the mad bastard with me today didn't know that. So he did everything I told him, including stealing an ambulance. Molly called us about Stanley's medical transfer, which gave us a head start on the real ambulance. I looked ridiculous in the uniform, but our documents were perfect. So I kept my head up and let Stanley inspire my confidence. Even so, I nearly fainted when the guard wheeled him out on the gurney. He looked dead already. The guard loaded him on board and I drove us away. 5 minutes out and the mad bastard dosed both the guards with the anesthesia. And just like that, Stanley was free.
Wow, sounds really compelling. Resume. There we go. All right, I forgot.
Shit. That water smells. No wonder there's so many bugs.
Right, I forgot I have to keep getting these journals.
Rory hosted a wake at his pub for the victims of Wednesday. I think he was just trying to show off. He got arrested last year for dealing, and the police broke his hand, so suddenly he's all political. Stanley and I sat in the car for a long time, watching the front door swallow all the black suits until the pub looked like it was filled with ink. Stanley opened the car door, but I grabbed his arm and asked him to take me to our tree. I felt a crippling anxiety that if I went into that black pub, I'd never see the sky again. Stanley didn't say a word. He just started the car, and we drove away.
Because that's mature. Just run away from all your problems. Maybe that's why you're in this situation that you're in now, because you couldn't stop running away from everything. Okay, there's like a scarf hanging there. Can I grab that scarf? No? Okay. Scarf cannot be grabbed. But what's in the water? Okay, there we go. Door? And there's a drain. So I'm assuming I need to drain this water, and draining the water gives me access to that door, and that door has a way to get somewhere. That's just the assumption that I'm coming to.
Oh, Christ. I don't even want to think what's growing in there. Oh, that's rotten. Oh, Christ.
Okay. So I guess the method would be to how to drain that pipe. Would be what I'm looking for. But I need to figure out how I would do that. How does one drain that pipe? Looks like this is the way you can walk. Ah! And there seems to be pipe drain.
Let's see if that helps with the smell.
Will it? I feel like that's just gonna make it worse, right?
Nope. Now we can see what I'm working with.
Let's go all the way down here, because it's kind of hard to see anything when you're down here. It doesn't look like there's anything selectable. So, want to make sure no journals fell down there, because I gotta get them all, you know. Alright. Let's see. I want to put a preface here. This game shit the bed earlier. Before I started recording, when I loaded up the game, it was like, hey, I'm going to give you every achievement but the one for collecting every single log, which was weird. I can show you. Look at all these achievements that I have. I acquired them. I acquired all of them at various times. Look at that. Look at that shit. It's like someone played my game for me. Isn't that weird? Like a ghost played my fucking game while I was gone, but it still says I only played it for 1.4 hours. So someone like somehow it just gave me everything, gave me every single achievement, which is really weird. I think that's kind of, yeah, I don't know. Like I said, it's only 1.4 hours completed on my record. So obviously as those who've played this game before or know anything about this game, you know that that's like completely impossible. Like, you can't get every achievement in 1.4 hours. So, something is the wrong. But what is the wrong? I don't know. Let's see. Oh, that's locked. Well, I guess I gotta keep going up then. Let's keep going up and... Ah, and now that pipe is free. Now that pipe's free, we can probably do this.
What? That's it? Is that all you got? Oh, you bastard. Need to figure something out. The bugs are still there.
Ugh. Alright, I see what I see what's going on here. I am fully aware of the puzzle that is being presented in front of me, and I'm going to solve it in a capacity that would be befitting of somebody with higher intellect and the ability to disconcern things that are going on. So you, take the scarf.
This makes no sense.
What? What are you? Why are you wearing the scarf, ya doofus? You're nothing but a dumbass. All right. So the entire point of the scarf is, would be to, for the bugs, right? Would be for bug prevention? Yeah. Yeah. So wearing the scarf means the bugs can't get in, the bugs can't bother me. So, cause I'm presumably I'm covered everywhere else 100% cause I'm like snow covered or whatever. But the only problem is like now I can barely see out of this. Which is weird, because I can't move fast either, but whatever. So let's try it out. Should be fine.
Oh, Jesus.
Well, it seems to be working.
Almost there, Leonore. Almost there, love.
Okay, I was gonna say, am I gonna be stuck like that forever now?
Mother Mary, Paddy has been killed. The British papers named it the Boxing Day Raid. But it wasn't a raid. Around here, they're calling it the Wednesday Massacre. 7 people shot down on the day after Christmas. I don't know what they're meeting about, and I don't want to know. They were all violent men except for Stanley's father. What was Paddy Whittaker doing there? But how did he hear about the meeting? Was he trying to talk them out of whatever they were planning? I need to find Stanley. He must be going through hell.
Ugh, God. So much drama. Alright, well. Let's see here. Oh, I guess we're climbing again. Oh, there we go. I was like, are we climbing or what? Can I just hold it? I don't remember if I did that last time. Alright, so I have to keep clicking. Gotta keep clicking. Gotta click. Click more. The faster you click, the faster you climb. Alright. Oh, right. We still have the light, too.
Oh, shit. Jesus. I can do this again.
Okay. I'm glad you can, because we need you to. If you don't, then we're not getting anywhere. Really glad that guy had climbing tools on him. That would have been really tough. If that guy didn't have any climbing tools, we'd be basically stuck. The game would have just ended, and we would have just died in the snow. But, fortune favors the weak. Let's see.
Oh, fuck. Oh, Christ. Don't look down. Don't look down.
I mean, it's fine. Just really tall up. But he got, like, one of those weird things about, like, wow, I'm so high up, I'm scared of heights. Eh, it's fine. It's just the height.
One step at a time.
I mean, okay. I'm so immersed. Look at all these hills. Is this the right hill? Oh, it is.
Leonore. Where? Oh, No. She's not here. Please tell me what you want. I've done everything I could. Everything. Haven't I done enough? Haven't I done enough? Oh, please.
What? Okay.
Where?
Do you know who I am, boy?
You're Leonore's father. Michael O'Shea.
You know my name, but do you know who I am?
Yeah. I know exactly who you are.
I was afraid of this.
I was there at the Rinsdale massacre when your father died. I didn't agree with him, man. I thought he was naive. He called me a terrorist and a criminal, but he said it to my face. I respected him. That's why I agreed to meet with him that day.
You agreed? You think my father told the police? Is that it?
I know exactly who it was. That's why I'm here. Rory Cochran is a police informant.
Rory?
They turned him after his arrest, dealing drugs of his own pub.
No! He's a mate! There's no way!
Stanley, come back to me.
What do you want from me?
Leonore. I need to know she's gonna be with a man who can take care of his obligations. Take care of his family.
I would. I will.
I'm gonna give you a chance to prove it. So you tell me, are you gonna do what needs to be done?
I don't know, maybe? I don't know what needs to be done. Oh, oops. Did I go the wrong way? I can never tell. There's a lot of doors. A lot of doors, but no open ones. Oh, maybe I'm supposed to fall into the pit. Before going all the way back up, let's see if maybe I'm supposed to fall into the pit. The pit of light, of righteousness, of correctional. There we go.
Mister, can you find my dad? Tell him I want to go home.
There's like literally no one here. What? Can I go in these doors? No, no. Well, I think there's supposed to be people here, but there's not people here? Or no, there's another door over there. Probably supposed to go to that door.
This isn't right.
Shut up! What am I supposed to fucking... Oh, there we go. Like, what am I supposed to fucking do?
If you're looking for the little girl's dad, he's over there throwing darts.
Okay.
Okay, okay. I'll be right over. And tell her not to forget her scarf.
What? Why am I doing this?
Not to forget my red scarf. I know. He always says that. I just hope he hurries.
Okay, I'm having a conversation with invisible people. This is really weird. Well, I guess I've done what I need to do. I don't know where the keys lead. Into here.
Oh my god. No, not again. Christ.
Oops.
Life is but a dream.
Oh my god, I'm burning up! No. I'm okay. I'm still alive. Thank God. Oh, Christ. Okay. I'm okay.
Where are we and how did we get here? Dude, you just blacked out for a long time. That's, like, not okay.
I thought things were getting better. I had hoped we were moving forward. I believed in Patty Whitaker's message. Violence can't be the answer. But now, he's gone. Rory's pub was bombed last night. Thank the Holy Mother, Rory closed the pub for his birthday party, but 16 people died. One of the victims was a little girl. The last time we were attacked like this, my father went mad. He poured liquor on his anger until it was an inferno that nearly engulfed us all. Now, he's as silent as the grave. And that's even more terrifying.
Well, sorry about your daddy issues. I'm definitely not in the mood to deal with them. But there's a lot of stuff I gotta deal with, apparently. Ah.
Steam. It's putting out the fire.
Cool. That's handy. I'm glad we can keep this steam mechanic going as long as possible. Alright, let's see.
I was freezing. Now I'm burning up. I don't know which one is worse.
Freezing. Freezing is always worse.
There she is. Oh, shit.
Figured that was going to happen.
I'm coming. Just hold on. It's almost over. Ah! Oh, fuck. What the fuck? Jesus Christ.
Okay. There's a lot of fire. Man, Leonore, you said you were freezing, but now you're burning? I'm so confused on what you want. Hmm.
Oh, Stanley, thank God! You're alive! I saw you standing on the hill! Hurry, Stanley. The fire is coming, and the smoke is getting...
Still alive. Still alive.
Okay. I don't know what purpose that serves, but I'm gonna go check over here and see if there's any journals lying around.
Stanley and I decided to venture farther into the city tonight. He said we shouldn't cross into East Belfast, but I didn't care. I was feeling brave. When we saw the party, it looked deadly, so I dragged Stanley up the steps. I love going to parties where nobody knows me. I can be anyone I want. I told Stanley to pretend this was our house. We wandered about, making up stories about where we got each bit of furniture. I was talking about the grandfather clock from Borneo when some drunken arse turns and tells me I'm full of shite. Turned out he owned the house. Then he asked us where we came from. A crowd started to gather, and the wrong answer could have spelled trouble. Stanley threw his arm around the man and said, "We're from Texas, America." And the man's face lit up. He loved America. Stanley's accent was ridiculous, but his confidence was inspiring, so they believed every word. It was wonderful.
Well, I'm glad to know that you can't put on a good Texas accent. Also, it's interesting that they would believe that even if they were drunk, given the fact that you do not sound like a Texan whatsoever. All right, so now I just need to turn this way. What? No, turn it. Wait. Yes? Ah, the tree fell. Okay.
Made it. Come on, Stanley. No! You son of a bitch!
Just crawl under it. What?
The fire roars around me. It wants to crack me open, to burn its way inside to the deep center of my core, where I still feel frozen and cold. Oh, shit!
Hmm. Oh, okay, this way is just opened up now all of a sudden. Okay, sure. I'll believe everything that you have to say. Okay. Weird. Is this the right way to go? I feel like I probably should have moved that thing to the other direction.
I've got to clear the path.
Ah, yeah. That's what I was worried about. Okay, so that wasn't the right way to go. More likely I need to do this, turn it one more time. I'll probably point over this way, turn out this fire, yep. Oh, lucky me.
Until now, I never knew how much my father hated Stanley. And the man has always had his secrets, but he's never just lied to me. He tried to tell me about why Stanley was really arrested and the truth about Rory Cochrane. But I can't believe what he said about Stanley. I can't. All those people. Stanley would never.
Wait, you think I blew up the place? Also, why is there dartboards here and the pub? This is all still just in my memory. The whole thing is just made up. I'm just a lunatic. The entire Fidelio incident is just me having a really bad nightmare of me trying to overcome my problems.
Belfast is so cold, the air feels brittle in my lungs. No matter what I do, I just can't seem to get warm. The other night at Rory's pub, I asked Stanley if he'd take me someplace warm. like another country. He said that if he did, we'd never come back. But the thought of it sounded so grand. We spent the rest of the night talking about traveling to exotic lands. How we'd meet people we couldn't understand, and we'd eat spicy food until our faces flushed and the sweat ran down our backs. I don't think he knew how serious I was. We should leave this broken island while we still have a chance.
There's always a chance. You can always leave. That's always an option. We live in 1900s. 19th century? 20th century? Whatever. Yeah, you live in the 20th century. There's plenty of avenues to take to get out of a place you don't want to be in. Okay, wait. Oh, I was like, wait a second, something's wrong here. I should have been able to do something, and I didn't do something. Alright, any more journal? Any more boring journal entries into the past of people? I'm starting to get more and more bothered by being around the more I hear about them. Happy birthday, Rory. Makes no sense. Alright. Interesting. Well, just keep on going, now that I can go underneath there, which I guess I need to for some reason. I see. Then you switch it over.
Hope that clears the path.
I'm pretty sure it did. I think that was like the whole point. The whole point was that it cleared a path. Now this is all clear. Man, this place outputs so much fucking steam. It's kind of ridiculous, honestly. Like, you think about it, in a realistic sense, how much steam is being produced on this one little island? Like, how much volcanic activity or heat has to be, or how cold does the outside air have to be that just regular air would create, like, powerful enough steam? What a weird concept for a world. Alright. Perfect. So, let's go up here. Hopefully we can get out of this fire.
Leonore!
Stanley? Hurry! The fire?
Listen to me! I have to leave you!
Wait! No! You can't!
Those vents there!
Please!
If I just let the steam out, they'll keep the fire away from you. But I can't do it from here.
Don't leave! Not yet!
You'll be fine! I promise! I promise.
Please, stay with me. Don't leave.
Wow, you're so interested in getting saved. All right. Did we just bring the pub with us? Is that why there's pub fragments everywhere?
Jesus Christ! I'm back to where I started.
No, you're literally not. This is not where the plane crashed originally. Your plane crashed, like, super far out. Oh, that looks spooky. Well, with that out of the way, I'm gonna go ahead and say thank you guys for watching. If you'd like to see, go ahead and click subscribe! Otherwise, leave a comment in the comment section below to tell the worst Fidelio incident player you've ever seen before. As always, thank you guys for watching. See you guys next time, and
bye!